Hello, and welcome back to the Vixen Voice. This is our second installment of Girl Talk. So you might have heard the episode where my two best friends grilled me about my trip to Spain, even about Spanish men. If you missed that, check it out. So today we are here with Jessica Weaver and Cindy Olah. You have met them before on episodes. Jessica is the founder of the Woman's Wealth Boutique, a good friend of mine that I met almost a year ago here in Nashville before I even moved to this town. Cindy is a coach of mine. We work together. And if you haven't heard our episode about women and pleasure, you should definitely listen in. By the way, Cindy, last week my mom was in the hospital and we were kind of hanging around talking, so she's all good now. And my dad goes, "Do you have a lot of men that listen to your podcast?" And, you know, I recorded all of these never thinking my parents are listening, right? And I was like, actually, 60% of our listeners on YouTube are male. And he goes, "I learned so much about women in the first three episodes, like more than I've learned in 74 years. And he was talking about our episode as well. So I love it. So women, if you want to educate your men, just invite them to the Vixen Voice. So good to have you here. And Cindy is the founder of Sacred Garden Yoga in Marietta, Georgia. And I love she also has virtual classes and a mystic school. So definitely check it out if you're curious. And finally, last but not least, we have Paulina Petkoski. And Paulina is a client of mine. We got to know each other through the internet. And she is a fashion stylist and entrepreneur in Detroit. So Paulina, welcome to the Vixen Voice.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
I love it. So Paulina, before we dive in, by the way, today we are talking about your ideal purse. And this is just in time for the holidays. So if you need to, it might be a great time to have your significant other listen in, right? So we're going to be talking. I love this topic because every time I ask a friend or someone I've met, "Hey, what's your ideal purse?" they talk to me for 20 or 30 minutes. In fact, Cindy and I have had this conversation before, so I'm excited she's on today. And so, you know, it's a little bit of a fun topic, but it could be useful with the holiday season coming up. So you might want to check it out. So Paulina, since you are new to the Vixen Voice, I'd love it if you wouldn't mind sharing a pivotal moment. You know, we have this beautiful woman sitting in front of us who's lived many places, is back home in Detroit, in her hometown, and just kind of share with us maybe a pivotal moment that made you the woman you are today.
I would love to. So I think one of the most pivotal moments I've had as a woman and in my career is when I decided that I wanted to study fashion. And I looked at schools in Michigan. And after feeling like I wasn't satisfied with the options here, I applied to the Fashion Institute of Technology in New York. And I was accepted, but there was a but. I was waitlisted. The campus was full. There was another but I could study abroad. I was pre-approved to go study in Italy for the year at Polimoda. And so I had never really thought about studying abroad. It wasn't something I had planned, but I did what any smart woman would do. I said yes. And I had never, been to Italy. I never spoke the language. And I was so excited. And that experience really changed my life and was such an amazing time and experience for me personally and also in my fashion career.
I love it. Where is Polimoda in Italy?
It's in Firenze, Florence.
I thought so. Okay, very cool. Very nice. Yeah, I lived in Milan for a while, so we'll have to have another conversation about that. We'll have another girl talk about living abroad. So I love it. So again, today we're talking about our ideal purse. And by the way, if you're listening to us on your favorite podcast app, this full episode is featured on our YouTube channel, Vixen Gathering. So check it out because we're all going to be showing and telling today. So you might want to check us out on YouTube. So I'm going to start with you, Jessica. By the way, I'm loving the floral. what would you start with? What is, you know, either tell us kind of what you look for in a purse, what your ideal purse is, or maybe share what you're loving now.
Ooh. Okay. So I am all about the backpack. I love an amazing backpack for a few reasons. One, I have bad neck issues. So if I have a heavy purse on my one side, it's usually going to cause a knot, stiff neck, those kind of things. I look for one that is lightweight. This one's nylon that I have. It's got a fun cheetah print for those of you who aren't watching. I love a good print. It's got cushioned straps, which is very helpful for me.
Oh, nice.
Especially if I'm traveling. I go to a lot of conferences, speaking engagements. So I also need a backpack that can fit my MacBook in so I can travel. I do a lot of my writing for my blog, books, while I'm flying, actually. It's very inspiring to me at that time. And this one also, it's like a nylon, so it's light, but I have young kids. I have a 3-year-old and a 6-year-old. So this one I know I can wipe off and it will be clean. And it also has plenty of room for snacks because my kids are snackaholics and I constantly need to have backup to my backup of backup snacks. And then I'm so busy, I forget I need to eat too. So I have my own snack pile in there as well. And I was going through this and this, you can see I'm a mom. And room for dinosaurs as well in my backpack. My son, he always has to hold something. So I end up having random toys all thrown through here, usually a journal and a pen because my daughter likes to draw and write and play around with those kind of things. So I need a bag that has some room for it, but it doesn't feel huge. So that's why I've been leaning on the backpacks a lot lately.
I love it. And I love that you qualified you have snacks too, because I was going to say I'm a snackaholic. I would have my own snacks in there. So especially traveling, I mean, it's so tough if you, you know, want to be careful what you're eating and fuel your energy. It's so important to have smart snacks with you. So I love it. Yes. You threw me a curveball with the backpack, but I like it. I'm going to talk about backpacks for traveling too, but I love that. So that's your everyday go-to right now?
It is, yes. And it has, I always have a little bag with my lipsticks within it. I usually carry 5 to 7 different lipsticks depending on what I'm feeling for the day, my outfits. But my backpack, it's not going to be my date night bag. It's not going to be if I'm going to a bridal shower or a luncheon, something. I want to get a little bit, and I did bring another bag. This is when I love a nice black go-to bag. And right now I've been rocking the YSL bag. Beautiful. I love that it can make it, you can make it long or a shoulder bag. And this has plenty of room for snacks too, ladies. It's divided into 3 compartments, which I love. So that's another piece. I love when I can find something easily. If I know I'm going to put my keys in this pocket, I consistently can get my keys there. Systems and processes. I love.
I love the lipstick bag, and I think it's so critical because I'll never forget when I first started buying nice purses. I had a small one and I didn't think about it, and my lipstick came, you know, got on the interior of the bag, and then I was sick. So since then, I always, I mean, even if it's a plastic Ziploc bag because I'm traveling, like it's in something. So
I didn't even think of that, but you're right. That's a great idea. Doesn't get a mess.
Yeah, keep it organized. Awesome. So Cindy, how about you? What are you rocking these days, or what do you prefer?
Well, Jessica, we were talking about having young kids. My child is now 18 years old, but I remember when he was a toddler and younger, I would go for the bigger, you know, purses or the bigger bags because you have to stuff all the things in there. But now that he is grown up, I actually prefer carrying something smaller. I usually go for something that's, I like something that's usually wider.
Ooh, I like it.
And not as tall, because I have some purses that are deep, but then, you know, you go digging in there and then you can't find stuff at the very bottom of the purse, and that drives me crazy. So I like a purse that is wider and not as tall. I like them to have handles here, and I like them to have a strap as well. That is like my ideal purse, for them to have this handle and then the straps that you can also take off. Because if I'm like running around and I don't want to be holding something, I prefer doing it like a crossbody. And my purse needs to have a pocket in the front. So that's the actual pocket. That's not the actual zipper. That's the zipper. And then there's a pocket in the back. So lots and lots of pockets for me because of, like you're talking about, keys. I hate losing my keys in my purse. And phones, because I have a couple of cell phones, unfortunately, that I have to keep track of. So anything that I can keep, you know, in the smaller pockets. And then, of course, the little pockets on the inside for the lipsticks, because I usually have like 3 or 4 different lipsticks in mine as well. And, you know, whatever else. And so that's usually what I look for in a purse, is for them to have lots of pockets, to be wider, and to have multiple, like, straps, lots of straps. And usually a color that's like this color. I like the gray. I mean, I like fancy colors too, but, you know, you're talking about quality. I do, now that I have an older child, because when you have younger children, and yeah, you know, you're going for the purses that you don't mind if they get spit up on, or if you get chocolate on them, or whatever stuff that ends up getting on a purse. But now that he's older and I don't have to worry about that, yeah, like, I prefer a nice quality because I like durability. So that is usually, and just like a more classical, more traditional type of a style too. That's what I go for.
Thank you. I love it. So, Cindy, you're talking about you don't like deep because you can't find things. I don't know about y'all, but I find the smaller my purse is, the harder it is for me to find stuff. I'm like, it drives me nuts. I'm like, but I'm carrying this for simplicity and I can't find my house key. Like, it's absolutely insane. I don't know where it magically hides, but it's gone somewhere. So that's so fun. Paulina. So the cool thing is Paulina can talk to us from a professional sense and also a personal sense of a woman very much on the go around town. So Paulina, what's your preference, or what are you loving right now?
Oh my gosh, I don't know where to start. I mean, I definitely am a fan of a mini backpack. And I was going to say to Jessica, I would recommend like the nylon Prada bags. Yes. You can also find them, you know, on second hand. So pre-loved, as we also like to call them, on different platforms. I actually have a Prada nylon makeup bag that I keep with me. And it's great because it's really easy to like wash and wear. And the exciting thing too about those right now is that Prada has transitioned over to recycled nylon for all of their products. Mm-hmm. So now those are actually more sustainable, which is very cool and exciting. Personally, my dream bag would be an Hermes Birkin bag. I'm not there yet. But I think that's just like the quintessential classic and most iconic bag that you will have forever, which is another way to be the most sustainable, is really to keep any item in use for as long as possible. Mm-hmm. And then obviously pass it down to your children, or you can also still resell it because they continue to hold their value. But I'm not quite there yet. This is actually my newest bag that I wanted to show today. This is a Louis Vuitton Felicia Pochette, and it's convertible. So I think like the thing that's most exciting for me and like useful is just to have things that are convertible. Whether like Cindy said, you have like a shoulder bag and a strap, or a top handle that you can convert. I have a daily wear bag that I do that with, but this is cute. I mean, it's beautiful. And it has the epi leather, which is like very understated, but also, you know, very clearly Louis Vuitton. And then it's got this beautiful chain strap that you can either take on or off. And then the cool thing about this one too is that it comes with its own little, you know, like cash holder. And then it also has like separate places and card holders in there too. So I like to be able to, you know, wear this with or without this as a clutch for evening. And it holds just enough. It's not necessarily the most practical, but especially for travel or evening, it's great. And then just like to be able to just like grab it and go is nice. And I love the neutral color. You know, I am, you can tell I wear a lot of black, I'm sure, especially just being in the fashion industry. It's very, I don't know, it's just how it is. But, you know, I have a lot of black bags, but on my list right now is just no more black bags, really. I do have like a daily carrier from Rebecca Minkoff that I love. And that is a convertible bag that's soft and has a lot of zippers. I like hardware details too. So even though this bag has gold hardware, I typically do wear a lot of silver hardware. So having that to kind of make it more edgy and fun is something that I look for too.
I love it. I love the nylon Prada bags. That's like my go-to travel bag. I have the crossbody just for travel. And in fact, I'll just put it inside my other purse and then pull it out because it totally weatherproof, sustainable. And I forgot, thank you for reminding me that, yes, when I got that last one, they told me it was recycled because I had one like 7 years ago that just finally saw its better day. Usually Prada lasts, but I think I was running around the city too much. It was covered in dust. But anyway, I love that so much. So I have a whole bag collection. It's like my thing. So I can relate to everything y'all are saying. And what I love about, actually I have a shoe collection too. And I seriously have every nice bag and pair of shoes I've ever bought. And so a concept that came to me, because I like to go quality with shoes and bags, and they do last. And what I loved is when Paulina, we were having a conversation or she was sharing something, you know, her idea. So she's very much an advocate of a sustainable wardrobe. And she talked about being able to pass pieces down to your family. And even though I don't have kids, like that just touched my heart because I'm like, oh, my nieces are going to get like all of these beautiful things one day.
I mean, so lucky, so lucky.
They're counting the days, trust me. The older ones are. The young one doesn't understand yet. But she does ask me, Aunt April, when I get older, can I wear that sweater? Like, it's so funny at age 7 already. That's how they are.
My daughter does that to me. Will you keep that for when I'm older? Sure.
I love it. So yeah, I love that concept because I think we've kind of lost that in today's world. I don't know about you, but growing up, my cousin, you know, who was 2 years younger than me, when they were visiting, they actually lived outside of Atlanta. And when they came to Mississippi, like I would kind of pick everything out of my closet that was too small or I wanted to get rid of. And my cousin would basically go shopping in my bedroom. And like she was happy and I was happy that she was having fun, you know, getting to wear my clothes that I loved. And I don't know. It doesn't seem to be that common anymore. I even thought about when I moved from Houston to here, I wanted to have a swap with friends where we bring all our stuff and you just like go shopping through each other's things. I thought it would be so awesome. I mean, I always try to donate to like Dress for Success or some cause when I'm giving things away. So I feel it's useful, but I guess I'm going to share my purses in a second. But while we're on this topic, Paulina, what tips would you have if someone really, you know, because I have to credit, Paulina got me thinking, I didn't think about my wardrobe and sustainability because, you know, I own property in Honduras and I see plastic washing up on my beach all the time. And I am so thorough about recycling and everything. I mean, I was before, but I'm even more adamant about it when you kind of see it because there's so much debate about the environment. And honestly, I think both sides get it a little bit wrong. I think the truth is somewhere else. So I personally like when I can personally see things or become aware of them. So I want to thank Paulina for opening my eyes to this when it comes to fashion and consuming, you know, when we go shopping and really being thoughtful about, okay, if it's time to purge or dispose, how can we continue the use of this garment? Or being smarter about what we buy so that we can continue. So Paulina, do you want to share some tips with us today?
Yeah, I'm glad you asked. I actually have two fun stories or just based on what you said. One of my styling clients, I love her. She has a great collection and I help her now add, you know, trending designer bags on a, you know, seasonal basis, but also that are meant to last. So she, like you said, has this collection and now she can, you know, choose from different shades, sizes, styles. And as her collection's growing, I was shopping for her soon to be daughter-in-law, who's starting a new job in Washington, D.C. as a lawyer. And so I helped style a few looks for her at one of the brands I work with. And as a gift, my client gave her a Prada like structured gray purse that had a, you know, handle and a shoulder strap. So once she put that on with the whole outfit that I had just styled for her first day at the office, which is like with primarily men, she's so young, it really just gave her the confidence that she needed to take on this new role in this new part of her life. And it was just so beautiful to see what you're just talking about, is just like the ability to have something that you cherish and love and that's high quality, but then also see it go into its second life. And when it's no longer serving you, or if it's just collecting dust in your closet, there's really a huge opportunity. And there's actually just like, you're sitting on value. So luckily a lot of brands are now starting to have these like incentives and buyback programs, not just other platforms. Like there are platforms that I love for shopping, like The RealReal and Fashion File, even ThredUp. Like those are some of the, you know, best brands that you can also like, you know, find good authentication from too, which is important when you're buying designer bags online as well, as opposed to something like eBay, where they're not always authenticating those things. Secondly, I am also going to a clothing swap today. That there's a boutique in Detroit called Boro, and they are hosting a clothing swap tonight that I'm RSVP'd for. So I am bringing like less than 10 pieces, and we all get to do that shop and swap, which again is another great way to extend the life of the products that maybe just don't serve you anymore. So I think all of those are great resources, and I think there's, you're going to see a huge increase in this market. People are finally becoming, like you said, more conscious of what they're buying, how often they're buying, who they're buying from. And there's just so many great designer pieces out there that are, you know, made well and have high quality fabric. So even though leather is not necessarily the most sustainable material, due to the tanning and the water chemical use and stuff that's used in the processes, when you buy secondhand, I mean, that's technically a sustainable practice as well. So, you know, it's very hard to find a leather alternative. There's a lot of people who are doing that right now. And, you know, just to say, like, leather is still one of the best, most durable materials that we have, but it's just about really, you know, using it and finding it secondhand. It's not only just the same product, but it's also at like an amazing price point. So it's way more accessible and you don't have to get a knockoff. You don't have to get something that's been designed to look like the designer handbag. You can actually just have that. And I think as more people become more aware of this and understand that they can, you know, find what they want and get what they want, that is just really exciting for me. And I love to help clients do that. I do a ton of online shopping for that.
I love it. And what I like about the idea of secondhand is it's going to be unique because it's not the seasons, right? So you're not going to walk around and everyone has it, just like when you're shopping vintage. So, all right, Paulina, I'm going to put you in charge. I really want one of the snake purses from Tom Ford's last season at Gucci. I definitely could not afford them when that came out, but I love it. It was all purple and green.
Yeah. If you remember,
they did the kind of they did it a couple of seasons ago, like an homage, but I'm sure it'll cost me a small fortune, but I would love a Tom Ford designed bag from Gucci.
Well, that's the thing. There's so many iconic pieces, like even old Balenciaga bags or Princess Schuller bags or Chloe bags. Like those things, they were really at this time, like when it girls were happening and paparazzi and online blogs were like making them so iconic. But if they're, you know, now you're starting to see even the Gucci, the horse bit bag, yeah, which was like very 90s or something. And now that has been shown on the runway this season. And so those iconic pieces, even though they might not be trending at the moment, it's definitely always the case that things always come back in style. So you really don't want to get rid of those things because you'll regret it later. In a lot of cases, I have some regret actually myself, but yeah, they're always coming back. So it, whether it's this season or not, it is very special and people will notice, and it makes your outfit more unique.
Yeah, well, I still have all my bags, so I don't have any regrets. I'll show you in a second. But my other favorite tip is, I mean, I don't do this as a strategy, but I genuinely love fashion. So when I have time, I just love going to see what's in the shops. Mm-hmm. And then I get talking, you know, and I become friends with people working there just because they love that I appreciate what they appreciate. And so like my friend Parker at Valentino will call me and be like, there's this bag, 40% off. I swear you would love it. So like I buy a lot of even my new bags at like 40, 50, 60% off because he'll call me and it's like a great deal. So, you know, just follow your heart and what you love and what's important. So I'm going to grab mine. So this is my new favorite, which is Gucci. I walked in. I can't believe I'm carrying this, like my everyday bag, silver, but you know, I just went to Europe. This with a backpack for travel was ideal because everything was right here and I still have like, you know, my computer and everything. But Cindy, I love you talked about the pocket because when I travel, the front pocket is snacks. The back pocket is my book and AirPods and whatever I need on the plane. And the middle pocket is everything that needs to be secure, right? So I love this bag because it's fun, because it's silver, but it's still neutral and I really can get away with it. I also love it because we're talking about convertible. You can fold it down and actually pull out this beautiful chain. And then it becomes like a nighttime bag instead of like an everyday bag. So super cool. But this is my new favorite. I did not plan to buy it when I bought it. I went in to buy a pair of black heels and walked out with this bag, but I do not regret it. And the other thing I love talking about, I have very small shoulders. You can't tell with this poofy sleeves, but this one you can see fits right there. So like for me, it's perfect and I can put the chain on. So, you know, men, this is why you're challenged when you're buying a purse for the woman you love, because there's all these weird things that we need to have right so it fits us, right? So the best plan is say, honey, we're going shopping today. Here's your budget. And they will think you're the best thing on earth. I don't know, ladies, how would you feel if that happened?
Or have Paulina send a bunch of things.
Yes.
That they get to try on. That's what my stylist does. I even have my mom's calling her now and she'll send options. She'll send me things to try on. And Paulina knows your style. So tap into a stylist like Paulina. That is perfect.
Thanks, Jessica.
No, I love that idea. And then I found out that Paulina works at White House Black Market, which the sweater came from. And so even though she's in Detroit, I'm like, oh, so in the future, I can just call you and you can send me stuff, because, you know, I don't know why we live in this world where we hesitate to ask people we know to help us or do business with them. It's crazy to me. I mean, literally the mall's across the street, so I can go over there and buy the sweater myself, or I can call Paulina. I pay the same price and she makes money. Like, why wouldn't I support my friend and client, right? So really just, you know, think about the ways you can show up. And, you know, that's a big part of the Vixen Gathering is collaboration. I mean, Jessica and I were both financial advisors. We're great friends. We don't see each other as competition. Like, we always collaborated and we're there for each other. And, you know, I think this is like a beautiful part of today. So yes, I agree. You'll
be able to get Paulina.
Yeah, please.
Oh, sorry. So yeah, I just wanted to say the role I have with White House Black Market actually is with Chico's FAS. They own White House Black Market, Soma, and Chico's. Mm-hmm. And my role with them is a social stylist. So I don't actually work in store, but I can create digital lookbooks for clients. I can take product to your home. I can do one-on-one appointments in store, or I can even host a styling party with like your closest friends as well. So it's a really unique role and position, and it's called social commerce. And I think that's something that you'll be seeing a lot more as retail and e-commerce evolves. So it's a really fashion forward position that I'm excited to be a part of that role in.
I love and then stylists, like, sorry, April, no, Paulina, because online you can't see the texture, the quality of the fabrics, but Paulina is touching it all day long and she knows how it's going to fit and drape. So it helps making online shopping even better. Just want to throw that in there.
No, I love that. And, you know, Paulina also does private work where you just pay her hourly and she'll go to whatever shop you want or do whatever. So I just love how flexible it is to work with stylists. So I did want to share, this is my very first expensive purse that I ever bought in 2014.
Nice.
And you can, you know, it's a black bag. I used it every day and you can see it's like in perfect condition. I still use this bag. So beautiful. I just wanted to show how, you know, when you do go quality, it actually, it's so crazy. This bag cost me, I don't know, in 2014, $1,600. But at the time I was probably buying $200 black bags. So you do the math. If I had bought a $200 black bag every year since 2014, I'm getting off better buying this bag, right? Because I didn't buy other black bags because I had this. And second, I'm not adding to trash around the earth or things needing to be recycled, right? So I just
That's good
that
girl part. Math.
I think so. Mm-hmm.
Long-term investments.
Yes. But, and never put your bag on the ground, by the way. That's why I'm trying to find a place to
Absolutely.
Put my bag. Never on the ground. So
I hate when a restaurant doesn't have a hook under the bar. Mm-hmm. It makes me so mad.
Yeah, but I love it because you can think, and you know, we joke and say girl math, but it's absolutely true. You know, I'm going to spend money on a black bag before I spend it on a bright pink little baguette that I might get tired of in 2 years, right? So you can really think about being fiscally responsible and also sustainably responsible. And it flips the lid of why, you know, some people are like, I would never pay $1,400 for a bag, which by the way, I'm sure this bag would be like $2,800 today, something like that. Paulina, what do you think this bag costs today?
Probably something around there. I did just find something so similar for a client and it was secondhand, but she's very specific about the type of logo it was because they have different types of logos. So it was like the same style, but it was a little bit of a hunt, which is fun.
That's funny. No, I like the triangle logo. Go ahead, Cindy.
I was just going to say, April, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt, that I always think about who I'm supporting as well. Like this top, for instance, that I'm wearing, I actually got this at an art show, believe it or not. But an artist made this top, and it's actually a silk and linen blend. And I love textiles. Like I like, you know, finer textiles. And so it's like this silk and linen blend. And she actually made this with, you know, ink that she created, like plant ink. And she used leaves to actually imprint, or I don't know, put these patterns on the shirt. And, you know, to know that one, you know, I like the quality, you know, silk linen. We can't go wrong with either silk or linen, as far as I'm concerned. And the fact that I was supporting someone, this was her art, you know, supporting her in her business. And yeah, and trying to support like some of those small businesses as well, even if, you know, not necessarily there's not a brand to it or a name to it, but the quality is there. And you know that you're just supporting someone in their passions. So I love that. I love doing that as well whenever I can.
I love that too. And I feel like maybe it was a backlash against all of the multi-level marketing and the home parties, but people started getting like, no, I don't like, why not? Why not talk to your friends, see what they're doing? Like, you're not going to buy something you don't want, right? I mean, you might find something that's amazing. You support them. You support this person. I love that you bought that from an artist. All of my artwork that I own, I know the artist. So that's really important to me, to actually know who the art's coming from. And one of my best friends, I met her at an art show. I bought a piece of art from her like back in 2018. And we're still great friends and we stay in touch. So I think it's just, you know, we joke about, I joke that all my friends now come from the internet, except for Jessica, because we actually met in real life. But most of my friends today in my world, I've met virtually, and they're exceptionally good friends, right? But like, you know, what can you do? Go to art shows, go shop vintage shops. Like, you'll meet new friends that love the same thing you do. And I don't know. I think it's such a fun thing about our world today that you can meet people really anywhere. So I love that. All right. So does anyone else have thoughts on purses? I have a question for you. So Jessica and Cindy, you're married. Do you let your husbands buy your purses, or do they stay away from that?
They have not. He has not gone near. He has bought me, not this, I have some very nice pieces through my stylist.
Yeah.
I've trusted him with, but not so far as a bag either.
You know, actually,
that's a lot of trust.
I know.
My husband did on his very own buy me this briefcase for my computer, which I thought he did a fairly decent job with picking that out.
Yes.
But that's about the only thing that that he's bought as far as like that goes. But yeah, I was like, good job.
So for all of you, if you're significant others, if someone asks, what do you want for Christmas? What are you answering? Because I'm totally single right now. I have no one I'm dating, but I'll never forget my ex-husband. One time he's like, what do you want for Christmas? And I was like, oh, I need new underwear. And I pushed him into the lingerie section at a department store and walked away. And he was like, and like, he did a great job, right? But it was like, I don't know, I have super funny stories. But he would always buy me perfume because he traveled a lot. So duty free, all my perfume came from him. So that was like pretty safe, and he knew what I like. So what are like some interesting things, Paulina, like maybe you've gotten from ex-boyfriends, or like, how do you handle that situation?
You know, I found that when I've had the opportunity, we go shopping together, because it's hard to style the stylist. It's just, I'm too picky. And, I think if they know me well enough, they would know that. So that's the best route. But, I'm looking for a new, like, everyday purse. I've had mine for quite a while, and I still love it, and there's nothing wrong with it. I just think I'm ready for a switch. So I'm interested in, I've been looking and stalking some things on the Real, some Saint Laurent bags. There's like a Sac du Jour. And then there's also kind of like a mini Speedy looking one, that's more like of a classic duffel style. So yeah, I just trying to find something that's not too big, because I will fill it up, but also big enough to put all the things and all the phones and devices that I need in them. So I need some flexibility.
Yeah, I think it's interesting. And I really do, you know, because I will share with you, you know, in my past life, I was a lawyer and a financial advisor. So I had many male friends, and so often they would call me and be like, what do I get my wife for Christmas? What do I get her for the anniversary, the birthday? So lucky those women that their husbands asked me, because I'm like, I remember my friend in Atlanta, it was their first year anniversary, and he was like, what do I do? And I was like, anything in a blue box, just go to Tiffany's and get her something. Like, just go do this. But I love that. No, my ex-boyfriend, I remember he came to me on my birthday, and he was like, I really wanted to surprise you, but I have no idea what to get you because you don't really need anything. I was like, oh, cool. I want new pajamas or workout clothes. Which do you prefer? And he was like, oh, I'm all about that. So like, he just took me to Athleta. he sat there checking email while I shopped. And then we went to the counter and I was like, you didn't even give me a budget. And he's like, I know, I was so excited. This is what you wanted. And like, everybody was happy, right? So I'm sharing this because I've seen it with my friends. Sometimes men feel so much pressure to get this right. And I think taking us on a mini shopping spree or asking us what we want, you know, a lot of times people look at you and say, oh, well, you have whatever you want, but there's always something we want. And we really, you know, and I don't know about you guys, but I'm weird. I don't love buying myself new workout clothes or pajamas, which is why I picked those two things. Are there things like you would rather be gifted than buy for yourself?
Yes.
Jewelry.
Yes.
Yeah.
True.
Definitely jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I agree. The workouts and the pajamas are my last thing that I will refurbish, replenish.
Yeah, me too.
Even though we use them every day.
I know. And I love them.
Underwear. Same thing. Yeah. I'd rather like the pretty stuff that people are going to see is what I want invested.
Well, we should talk after the show, ladies. I got you.
Yes, because I do buy all my pajamas from Soma, so you're my new supply.
I was thinking, yep, my mother and mother-in-law, I might have to reach out to you, Paulina.
Yeah, you should. We have a lot of special promotions for holiday. They're already pre-packaged, ready to go for gift wrapping. So yeah, I would definitely suggest that.
So I have one more question before we sign off and we might have another. So Paulina mentioned her dream bag is a Birkin. I am not into Birkin. So Jessica and Cindy, Birkin or no Birkin?
Mine would be a Chanel pink bag.
Yeah, I can
and it'd be
see
the one that I would
that
spend as much money. I wouldn't care. Pink is my color.
Actually,
that's always been my heart.
Come up. I knew this was going to come up. So everyone asked me what my souvenir was from Spain. Oh. So you're going to love this. I told you I won't spend a ton of money on color, but here is, this is my new favorite, Jessica. You're going to want it.
That's so cute.
So it's a wallet going inside my silver bag, but it has a chain so I can wear it as an evening bag.
The chain's
bag
so pretty.
Too.
It's like
gosh,
a necklace.
They're so soft. So,
because yes. It matches my lipstick, I think it should come over to me, April.
We're going to have a barter system. What am I getting in exchange? Awesome.
Yeah, trade.
Okay. A kid. You can have one of my kids.
I'm okay. Let's see. So Jessica is pink Chanel. Is it the quilted one? Like traditional Chanel pink?
Yes,
or
traditional pink Chanel. Mm-hmm.
Love it. Cindy, how about you?
I would go for a traditional black Chanel.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I love that I got this because Chanel a couple of years ago had a quilted. I love gray. Like I love gray. And it was a gray bag,
too.
Kind of the color of your bag. Quilted with a chain where it was like casual enough to wear. And I don't know, at that point in time, Chanel's just a little price tag up. I just couldn't do it. And that is one of my regrets that I didn't purchase because I would have kept that bag forever. But, you know, you have to do what's fiscally responsible as well. We are not advocating that everyone go buy their dream bag. It has to make sense for you. Awesome. Well, ladies, this was super fun today. Any parting thoughts or anything you'd like to share as we sign off?
No, thank you for having us, April.
Yeah, thank you. This was really fun to have some girl chat about bags. We should do this more often.
Yes.
Yes. I agree.
Yeah, I enjoyed it as well, too. I learned some things as well, which is great. So, yeah.
Oh, me too. Same. I took notes as Paulina was talking. I'm checking with her. I'm gonna re-watch
it's
this
episode. It's
so much
easier to have an expert on.
I totally agree. No, Paulina, I agree with you. I actually already have this idea you and I can chat about. I think we should have virtual swap parties. Like we had our Vixen launch party. I've been wanting to have monthly parties, like watch parties, because it was, you know, people enjoyed it so much. I think it'd be super fun. We can figure out, all of us can sponsor it in our areas, how to have virtual swap parties. That would be super fun. So let's chat about that and make it happen. And ladies, if you're listening, see how fun it was to talk about bags. Go out, have a glass of champagne with your friends, talk about bags, forget about how expensive things are, forget about the economy right now, forget about who's in charge of politics. Let's just, you know, sometimes it's fun just to have fun. So make sure to have time in your calendar for joy. I love it. Ooh, Jessica, do you want to sing a little more for us?
Girls just want to have fun. That's all awesome. They really want. A horrible voice.
So I think that's the perfect ending. Ladies, thank you so much. It was so fun. And as always, it's amazing seeing your beautiful faces. So today, if you enjoyed listening, you can follow all of our amazing guests. The notes are in our show notes. You go to vixengathering.com/podcast. Also, if you're watching this on YouTube, the information will be there. So definitely follow them. You never know when you need an amazing financial advisor, yoga teacher / mystic, or a stylist, as we all feel we now need. And also, Paulina promotes artists as well. So she does lots of cool stuff. So I'm sure you love our guests as much as I do. Please follow them. And if we can help you in any way, we'd love to. In the meantime, remember to have fun. Remember to get what you want. And remember to live the life that you want. Thank you, everyone. Have a fantastic day.
Thank you.